Hey everyone, God bless you. Welcome back to my channel. In this video, you saw me last week hammer out this Bowie knife out of 24 layers of steel. Or we started with 12 and we ended up with 24. What a job that was. I actually etched this knife blade. You won't be able to see it on this particular video. It turned out not exactly the way that I thought it would, but it still did turn out pretty nice. Now, I told you that I had ordered some brass for the handguard. So we're going to put together the handle for the knife today. I'm going to show you how to do that. By the way, this will be a giveaway knife when I'm done with it. I'm going to give this knife away to somebody who wants it. And I'd like to give a shout out to my friend Smelling Roses, who came out here in Bland County and found that knife that I had hid there for the other geocache giveaway. So my friend there, Smelling Roses, man, I really appreciate you coming out and giving my channel a boost by doing that. If you haven't checked out Smelling Roses' channel, this fella hikes all over the creation. I mean, he goes everywhere, he's at, he's always hiking, so he's got a really nice channel, and I appreciate my buddy Smelling Roses. But anyway, let's get started on this knife. I'm going to show you how to do it, and just one of the ways that I do it. Besides, you know how you've seen people take a block of wood and drill that hole down in there? Well, sometimes that's hard to do, and it's hard to get it straight, okay? So what I do, and what I'm doing for this particular knife right here is I've took my walnut. By the way, thank you, Frank, for that scrap walnut you sent me. I've took my walnut, and I've mortised out half the size or half the depth of this, half the thickness of the handle that's going down in there, okay, the tang. Half that thickness on both pieces of that block. I mortised that out, glued it together, and then last night I glued a piece of wood on the back of it for the backstop. Now, you know, a lot of people think that right there will come apart, but once that glue sets up, the wood will break before the glue ever breaks. And I'm going to epoxy this on when we're ready to go. But I just wanted to show you that's how you can do it and not have to drill a hole down in there to get that to get it to work on your knife. All right, now that I've cut some of the excess away, you can get the picture right there. Now we will glue this, after I get the handguard made, we will glue this onto the knife and then we'll go from there. That's what it looks like. See that? By the way, this... Another thing you will discover there when you're doing this is whether or not you got your knife tempered right, and then the temper drawed on it, or hardened and tempered right. All right, you all see what I did to the tang? Always cut or file you some notches into that, even though you're going to epoxy this in. You don't just want it sitting back there with smooth all the way around. This will make it hold a whole lot better, okay? So that's what you want to do. Now let me smooth that up just a little bit, and I'll show you how that sits down all right, so there's what we'll do. Now we'll make the handguard, and we'll put it on here. Then we'll just glue it in place, and we'll let it sit there until it's time to turn this chunk of wood into the handle of this knife right here. Now you all, before you go to cutting into that brass you ordered, make you one out of a piece of wood first and get it to fit right. Then you'll have your pattern for your brass and you won't do like me and mess up. Well, no, one thing I want to thank Mr. Grimmel there, because it sure makes that job a whole lot easier, you all, once you get your hole cut in there. Instead of having to do all that hand filing. Now, this is the wooden blank. Let's see if we can get it to work on a knife. See where we're going there? Now we'll draw that onto the piece of brass, and we won't be, guessing where the hole goes or anything else. We've got that design the way we want it to. Now, you all, I got a wood cutting, metal cutting blade for my bandsaw, and it just zips that stuff out like it's butter, okay? So now all we got to do is cut the hole in it to fit over the tang, and we'll be ready to glue it up. The way you want it to look, you all. Now, I got just a little space right there between that, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to bend that piece of brass so that it fits the blade right there. Anyway, that's what it's looking like so far. Okay, there it is, you all. There's the block of, there's our handle block. Now we're ready to glue the thing up. Okay, you all, I'm using 30-minute epoxy. Takes about 24 hours for it to cure, so make sure you mix up enough to do the job the first time, you all. Don't worry about it if it squirts out around your blade or anything like that. That's what you want to happen, because you want to fill in the cracks there at, where your guard is. And you want to have plenty air inside your handle to fit around the fit around that tang. Now, I am going to put rivets in this, but I'm going to do it later on. I did find the other day, if you people are interested in it, I know lots of people buy this stuff from these knife stores, and I have bought rivet material there too. But I went to Lowe's the other day, and they do sell brass rod. 36-inch piece, 1/8 inch, that's all they got. 36 bait, I think it's like $6 or $7. So there we go. Reach right there and just, if you want to, and get this particular little stuff right here. And I can see that it needs just a little bit of filler right there. And I could have put some tape on that right there, but I didn't. All right, we're getting started on shaping them handles, you all. Now, when you're working on this, you all, put you a piece of tape or something on there so that you'll have something that you can actually work to, that you won't have to eyeball that, okay? That's all that tape is. That's just a line to work to. All right, now we're going to draw us a shape on this thing, you all. We're going to work to that shape. All right, you all, here it is. Check out this knife. About 15 or 16 hours later, we've got ourselves a Bowie knife. Now, this Bowie knife, you all, it, like I said, is 24 layers. It's got walnut handles on it. I will later on do some decorating to the handle, because I'm going to give this knife away in a giveaway. I'll make a sheath for it. So I got just a little bit of decorating that I want to do to the handle for this particular knife. And I'm going to try to stamp my logo on it there. Anyway, it turned out pretty good. So somebody else get out there and hammer one of these out. I know you can do it. You watched me do it. So fire your forge up, stack your layers up, and start hammering, and let's see what you can do. You never know what you turn up to and do. Anyway, you all, God bless you. It's another tip from your Bland County Survival Man. Have yourself a wonderful day.